Hey guys, it's Monet here, and we're here to talk about Rose Era, the perfume I created with Sniff, and also the most iconic perfumer, Mathilde.
Hi, my name is Mathilde Bijawi, and I'm a perfumer, and I'm really proud today to be with Monet for this beautiful pink perfume.
Yes!
So Monet, what was your initial vision for the fragrance?
So when I finally had the opportunity to work on a fragrance, I had so many different ideas and like visions, and honestly, throughout this process, like, you've opened my eyes so much to just what you can create in fragrance. But one thing that was consistent was always a rose and just always the floral scents. We're in New York, guys, can you tell? So we started there and it just stemmed, no pun intended, into many different beautiful just notes. I'm so curious to see like how you brought that vision to life.
So it's really interesting because when you came to us with this idea of a floral, of a rose, it really talked to me because for me, rose is universal, and I really wanted to make a rose special for you. And rose is special for me as well because I grew up in a garden where we had like very beautiful roses, kind of this color actually, and they had like a very fruity, delicate smell. And I tried to recreate in the center of this perfume this kind of rosy from my garden. Dry down of the perfume is more like musk, ambrette, sandalwood, something creamy, very sensual, because I mean you're definitely someone who's very sensual.
Oh, okay.
And I really wanted to have something that when you wear it on your skin would even get more, you know, something more diffusive, blooming.
I love hearing you describe it because that really is how it feels.
So Monet, what is your favorite thing about this smell?
That honestly is so hard. I feel like it changes every day. I think I love that there's so many layers to it, honestly. Like, we start with the florals, we're definitely getting that moment, but there's also the fruity element that I love. It makes it so fresh and fun. And then also the clean element that I love that you can wear during the day, like after the shower, it can transform into like a night kind of perfume. I think she's so universal, but there's layers to it. It's been so interesting. My mom has been my right hand throughout this whole journey, and smelling it on her skin, it's different than it smells on me, and also my best friends kind of just like being in the lab with me. I'm so excited to see how everyone just loves it in their own way. So can you tell us some more about the specific notes in Rose Era?
Sure. So in the Rose Era, we have some ambrette. Ambrette is a seed that I really love to work with. It's something like between, it has some fruity pear effect, something very, very elegant. And so it starts with this note, and then I blended it with the strawberry. You remember the strawberry when we added kind of the end of the process? But it definitely starts from the real strawberry. So it makes the strawberry more natural, more visceral, and more like pink, you know?
Yes.
So, and then of course, in the heart of this fragrance, we have rose. So I'm gonna explain it that we have two different roses. We have the Rose Centifolia Absolue, which is very natural, very blooming. We also have the rose damascenite, another variety of rose, super essence. It's a different extraction. And this one is more clean, fresh, so both of it really blends really nicely. So then on the dry down, we have this Orcanox, which is a molecule that we have at Man that's really unique. It smells like a little bit of like amber woods. It's very sexy. Mm-hmm. It's both, actually I use it in both feminine and masculine notes, and it's really something that gives a trail, that gives long lastingness.
Yes.
So this, and we have a lot of musk. We have a very nice vegan musk. It's called Vegan Ambretolide, and it resonates with the ambrette on top notes.
The Orcanox itself, that is something you just need to smell. It's in some of my favorite candles. I've honestly learned so much too about the rose itself. I thought it was one thing going into it. It's like one note, like it's just a rose. Like no, there are so many different ways to smell rose and to highlight rose. And yeah, I think we landed on a really beautiful combination.
So Monet, why did you want it to include like a clean facet to the fragrance?
Oh, I feel like it's a must. One of my favorite things about perfume is just feeling, it's like the finishing touch. Like you get out of the shower, you do your hair, you do your makeup, and then just like that final touch of just clean, I feel like was important for me in the final fragrance. Like I just love that fresh feeling. And she definitely has it. What makes Rose Era different than any other kind of floral fragrance that you've made?
So in Rose Era, there's some like two elements for me that kind of make it more edgy and different. First one is saffron. I love spices. Like when I cook, when I create perfume, I used to be called Spice Girl when I was younger as a perfumer. And like saffron, it has something really interesting because it could be, of course it's spicy, but it's also kind of almost leathery, again, central. And then the clean laundry effect also is, I mean, it's used more in some other kind of product, but in fine fragrance, it's not that common. So I think that these both elements make this fragrance different, edgy, but still like contemporary.
Yes, she's unique.
So what are the three words that describe this scent?
Colorful, I feel like I love that idea. Just, I feel that way when I wear it, and also just all the fruits and just like colors in actual, like the notes in the fragrance. I think fresh definitely is one. I love that kind of light feeling, and then moody for sure.
Ooh.
She's moody. Like she starts one way, you know, she feels this way 30 minutes later, and then at the end of the day, it's like, okay, like, what do we have here? Like she transforms, like me. Like me, she moody like me. Okay, so I have to ask you, how do you feel when you wear Rose Era?
I love to work in colors, like we call it synesthesia, like all the senses kind of inspire me. So for me, when I saw you for the first time and you had like this mood board with pink, I really directly went, I chose my ingredient, you know, on my palette to smell like pink. So I definitely smell like pink when I smell,
yes,
when I wear it. I smell fluffy, you know, a little bit like that.
Yeah.
Like this perfume is fluffy, is like blooming, is like, and it's kind of easy to wear because as you said, it's fresh. And I think it's like spring, you know, it's like something very joyful, very, very.
That's what I was saying too. I'm like, that's what it reminds me of, is like that fresh bloom. Like after the most depressing winter indoors,
exactly.
It's like when you finally get to go outside and you finally like see colors and the flowers and, you know, the fruits, the sunset, like it definitely gives me spring, summer vibe. Thank you so much for creating this. This is like so special, and I just can't wait for everyone to get their hands on it. Y'all can go sniff it over at sniff.co, okay? She's available now. And yeah, we'll see you there.